Hello everybody, it's your non-binary pal Gracious Eva here, and this is another artwork of my character Aries. So if you remember a while ago, I made another artwork of my character Aries. Here it is right here. And interesting thing about this artwork, it's probably the longest amount of time I have spent on an artwork. The other one that I spent a really long time on was on this video, and I complained a lot about that one taking a lot of time. But in this case, I don't mind at all because I actually had a lot of fun with this drawing. This illustration and composition is based off of some images that I found on Pinterest, which had like the same color scheme and had this same like broken TV aesthetic with a bunch of plants around it. If you've seen those type of pictures, you probably know what I'm talking about. But yeah, like I said before, I have redesigned Aries before, and this is the other image that I kind of based that redesign on. But in this, they are actually more of a broken down robot character, again, to be the same as those Pinterest characters, and also so I can put like a TV in their chest. I've actually thought about this type of composition for a while, but when I found those photos on Pinterest, I knew that that was the direction I wanted to go for. And yeah, the sketching went completely fine, nothing too out of the ordinary there, and I decided to draw them in my painterly style since I liked how the sketch looked. And when my painterly style is literally just doing the line art with the same brush that I used the sketch for, it's pretty straightforward. The colors I used were actually from my night palette, which has a lot of blues and pinks and purples, very bi flag coded. And yeah, I like using this palette a lot. It's very nice. And rendering Aries themselves was very simple, very normal. I did try to spend like more time on like the cracks in their skin, again since I was trying to make them look like a robot character, and also the side of their face, which is kind of obscured but is supposed to be like broken down and like visually like pretty broken. You don't really see it too well in the final product, but that is kind of what I was going for. You gotta look for it. No, the thing that took the longest here was the trees, because I was trying a different technique. I decided to paint the leaves differently, and you'll see in a minute when I get to the background. Basically what I did was I started out with a one of my fancy painterly brushes that's like able to blend out the colors really well, and I blocked in the shapes there, took another brush to add in some texture, and then went over it with a standard leaf brush and lowered the opacity. I like how it looks here, and I've done this before in a couple other pictures after this. I don't think I'll stick to only painting trees this way, just because it is pretty tedious and does take a while to do. And also, like, it's a lot more like a whimsical look to the trees, like not a super realistic look. So I'll probably not do it for every illustration I do involving trees, but I really liked doing it nonetheless. And in the composition, I also had like flowers on the ground, but instead of making those super detailed, I decided to just have them be like these circle-y shapes. It almost kind of reminds me of the illustrations you would see in Dr. Seuss's books. I don't know why, it just sort of reminds me of that, and I think it adds to the vibe of a very whimsical but also alien-like feel, because yeah, the whole vibe is supposed to be like a very alien thing. Interesting thing about rendering Aries themselves is I kept forgetting about the wires that I included in the sketch, because I was gonna have these wires that were connected to them that were supposed to be like hanging from the trees. I did include those and they were easy to add, but I remember forgetting about those, and I was like, oh wait, I forgot about the wires, oh no. And I made the wires pink because of course. For the no signal sign on their TV chest, I tried different things for that. In the end, I think I just went with like a solid gradient, I think, with some hatching lines to make it look like kind of static-y, and then of course just a simple no signal sign. The eyes were interesting to shade because I wanted the light from the TV to hit their iris that's actually still there, but still look lifeless. I think I got it right to where it's like halfway between there's light reflecting in their eyes, but it is not light from life. It is just light from light. And I think the symbolism in this artwork is pretty obvious, but I'm not gonna explain it because you get to decide what it means, because that's the fun in art. You get to decide what the symbolism means, and I just let you do that. In the end, I remember using quite a few filters to add texture. I think I might have gone a little overboard, so when I edited it, because I did edit it later on because I realized the colors were a bit too monochromatic. I think I lowered the texture a little bit more, and I made the colors less monochromatic by using some gradient maps and correction layers. That's pretty much all I have to say for this artwork. It was really fun to do. The process was pretty simple, except for the background. Rendering areas themselves was like my typical process, and then I got to be experimental with the background and a little bit in the foreground. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the rest of the speed paint, and I will talk to you at the end. thanks again for watching this video. If you want to see more artworks like this, I have my Kara account linked in the description below, as well as my Instagram, my web comics that I have linked down there, and my Etsy shop, where you can find lots of cool things. And yeah, I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.